Hi, my name is Lala. Keep watching Broadway TV.
Hello out there. My name is Gideon Okeke. You're watching Broadway TV. Keep it locked.
Hi, my name is Kepi Ekwenyong. Keep watching Broadway Television.
Hi there. My name is Bimba Akintola. I'm an actor. Keep watching Broadway Television.
Hi, guys. My name is Abele Udo, the founder of African Designers Mall. Keep watching. Don't go anywhere. Broadway TV. Hi.
My name is Zara Udofia Ejo, and you're on Broadway TV. Keep watching.
Can you tell us what you think about
it? Amazing. I'm very, very proud right now to be a Nigerian. I mean, apart from the concept of the movie based on the Ebola, it's called the directing, everything. I mean, this movie could have been shot anywhere else in the world. It's amazing.
So what's your advice for Nollywood generally?
Do better, if we can surpass this. But I can't even think of anything else other than the message of this movie and what people, if you haven't come out to see 93 days, you don't know what you're missing. This is not just a movie. This is a message of what we can do as a people. This is a message that you don't need to steal to be a hero or a heroine.
Good evening.
Hi, good evening.
How did you enjoy the movie?
I really liked it.
Okay. So can you give us three reasons why people should come and see this movie?
First of all, it's a Nigerian film, and I think every Nigerian should come and see it. Secondly, it tells an important story. It tells the story of our heroes, and our history is trapped therein. Thirdly, the film needs to make money, so you all got to come and see it.
Okay, so what advice have you got for Nollywood? People that want to make movies, what advice should I have?
Make your movies. Just make it. You can say, you know, there can be so much conversations about all the quality. This, make the movie. When you make it, you will learn. If you don't make it, you will not learn. So just make it. Let's keep telling the stories and let the industry grow. So make it.
Good evening. You were fantastic in the movie.
Thank you.
Extremely fantastic. How was it changing your tonation, or how was it acting out that play where you had this funny accent a lot?
It's all around me. So it's just being attentive to all that, being attentive to myself, being attentive to the guy I'm playing as well. You know, just listening and doing it. And the director is there to tell you no or yes. You know what I mean? So yeah, I'm sure you can do it.
So if you had to give three reasons for people to come to the cinema to watch the movie, what are the reasons?
Oh, first of all, I mean, it's one answer that covers all three or even more. We all have a story to tell about 93 days. In those 93 days, I'm sure you called someone to say, hey, take precaution, be careful. I hear about salt water, I hear about, you know, I'm sure you called a family member to say, be careful. For that single reason, I think everyone should come see it. If you were here, because we're all invested in the story. That's just by way of being Nigerians. But by way of being world citizens, I'm sure you caught it in the news. You saw it in the papers, you caught it on the news, and as long as you've seen it, it's a true life story. So come see what, you know, see how these guys tried to maneuver 93 days into 2 hours.
Three reasons. One reason to see this movie is because it has all the qualities of a world-class movie. The thematic preoccupation occurred right here. It's a true life story, ladies and gentlemen. It's a true life story, and interpretation is near 100%. I don't buy the idea that the director thought it was 85%. I think it went beyond 100%. We all worked as hard as we humanly could to become all the people of this job. I think you need to appreciate it on your own, because I also played a role on it. It's difficult for me to convince you to go see it. So what I'll say to you basically is, for you, go out there, see it, and if you don't like it, get back to me.
First
and foremost, it talks about us. It's a part of us, a part of our history, something that happened in Nigeria. 93 days is about the 93 days that Ebola was in Nigeria. And it's about two, the heroes of that time, Dr. Agadeva, Nurse Justina, Madam Evelyn, the people that gave their lives so that we can be here today to talk about it. And we must honor our own.
So did you have any emotional moments on set?
A lot, but the most outstanding one would be the scene where she was talking to her son outside the hospital.
Alright, thank you so much, okay.
For the first time, our stories are being told by us, for us. Our heroic moments are being captured for the world to see. You know, for the first time, we have a movie that actually right on time comes to show how Nigerians came together to sacrifice, to fight resiliently, and to conquer a major global disaster that many other nations could not even surmount. And so we came, we led, and we did it. So just for you to even be proud as a Nigerian, or for you to actually see what exactly went down, and to understand how much went into saving our lives and our country, or for you to even see what could have been and be grateful to God that it never was, or for you to see an amazing work of art called 93 Days, you must come to the cinemas, Silverbend, Genesis, Film House, and all of it across the country, and you will enjoy every bit of it and know that your 1,000 naira was money well spent.
Well, my name is Edem Roxy Antap, and if I have to give three reasons for people to watch 93 Days in the cinema, and number one would be, first of all, you need to know the real story that happened. For those of us that don't really know what might have transpired during those 93 days, how these people were able to manage Ebola in Nigeria, the doctors, the ones that lost their lives, their names, their families, these people gave their life for us to be alive today, so they shouldn't be forgotten. Then, that's for the story itself, but if I have to give another reason, that's for Nollywood. I would say 93 days is an improvement for Nollywood. Nollywood has been improving recently, but this is something that if you're someone that patronizes Nollywood movies, whether you're an actor or you're a normal person, please watch 93 Days. Watch it in the cinema. Get your own CD because it's the kind of movie that has history. So you need to have yours at home. You don't just watch it and forget about it. No, keep 93 Days in your house. You can show it to your children or your grandchildren. This is how Nigeria was able to conquer Ebola at some point in time in Nigeria. Thank you very much.
Amazing. I didn't know how intense Ebola was until today. I was tearing.
Okay, so if you had to give three reasons why people should come see this movie, what would you say?
First, it's educative. It's about Nigeria. It's about what we went through and how we came out of it, you know? And being aware that we actually fight for our own. Yeah.
Okay. So did you style anybody on your fashion designer, yeah?
Yeah. So I own an online mall called African Designers Mall. So we style Bimbo, everything she's wearing, from Ade Bakari. Yeah, he sells on my platform. So any designer you want to shop from across the world, you can just go to africandesignersmall.com to shop any African design. So we're promoting African fashion across the world because we have a lot of talent here, and how more to do that than to have an online platform where anybody can shop with no restrictions.
One, it's a Nigerian product. It's a very good Nigerian product. Two, it is our story. We need to, yes, the crisis has passed. Yes, we dodged the bullets. But it is something that we should continuously remind ourselves of. We should not forget. So that it will help us prepare, you know, keep us on our feet, on our toes, to be ready, keep us ready. And then three, borrowing the words of Dr. Hay in the film, he said Ebola came to our shores. We did not know what it was, but Nigeria and Nigerians stood for Nigeria. This will teach us, I've become a little more patriotism conscious. I've become a little more
Nigerian conscious. You understand what I mean? I've become a little more hero conscious. I've become a little more legend conscious. We shouldn't wait until people have died, which is our culture, which is the norm, to celebrate them. We shouldn't wait until something is terribly wrong before we come together. If we could pull together to face Ebola without checking religion, without checking tribe or culture or ethnicity, we can pull together to fight corruption. We can pull together to fight bad governance. We can pull together to fight tribalism. We can pull together to fight terrorism in our country as Nigerians, not for anybody else, not for anything else, but for ourselves. Hi, my name is Lala. Keep watching Broadway TV.
Hello out there, my name is Gideon Okeke. You're watching Broadway TV. Keep it locked.
Hi, my name is Kepi Ekweong. Keep watching Broadway Television.
Hi there, my name is Bimba Kintola. I'm an actor. Keep watching Broadway Television.
Hi guys, my name is Abele Ugo, the founder of African Designers Mall. Keep watching. Don't go anywhere. Broadway TV. Woo!
Hello, my name is Zara Udofia Eju, and you're on Broadway TV. Keep watching.